Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. So today is gonna be another hair tutorial and it's gonna be how I curl my hair with volume. So I love it, it's a super, super easy tutorial. If you wanna learn how to get this look, then just keep on watching. All right, so we're just gonna jump right on in. So that sounded so country. So I have already just parted my hair in two. Literally, it doesn't matter, I just part my hair in two sections. If you have a little bit thicker hair or longer hair, then you might wanna section it off in more sections than just two, but I work with two and it works just fine. So we're just gonna start it off. I have already sprayed my hair with some heat protectant. Oh my gosh, I cannot think of words today. With some heat protectant, and I showered last night, so my hair is on, I guess, the second day technically. So we are just gonna start curling it. So I section my hair in two, and we will just go ahead and start. So the wand that I use is from Numi. It's N-U-M-E, and this is the 1.5 inch barrel, I'm pretty sure. So I got this a couple Christmases ago, I think, and I have loved it. It's one whole size, the whole thing is one size, and I really like that to kind of create nice beachy waves instead of like super tight ringlets. So that's kind of what I do, but we are going to go ahead and just start. So I work from the back forward and I always curl away from my face. So I'll start with the back section and I kind of vary with what how big of sections I get. Again, if your hair is really thick, I would go for smaller sections at a time. My hair really isn't, but yeah, so I take about probably about this much and just kind of work my way around. So I work from the back and I curl away from my face. And I always leave just a little bit of section out off the barrel, and that kind of creates a more beachy wave instead of a super tight ringlet curl all the way down. But I just wait for it to get nice and hot, and then I let it loose, and then I hold it in my hand for about 10 seconds. Because if you hold it in your hand, it lets the hair cooled down in this position instead of just letting it loose and it loses its curl faster, if I can talk. So, all right, we have one done and we will just keep moving, working our way forward. Just curling away from the face, leaving a section of hair out like this. Letting it loose, keeping it in your hand for a little bit. My dog's behind the camera. She's so cute. Like that. And then moving on. It's so easy, and this curling iron makes it so simple. Oh my gosh. Belle. No, no. I'm filming. Gotta be quiet. And don't worry, they won't look like Susie Q curls forever. We're gonna spray it out. So one side is already done, and then once I'm done, I kind of take my fingers and just kind of bring my hands through it a little bit. And then we'll move on. All right, so for this side, we're gonna curl away from our face as well. So just make sure that you're always wrapping the hair away from the face and you'll get the curl to go in the right direction. If you struggle with keeping your hair curled, then a trick that I did to keep your curls lasting all day long is instead of just holding the curl, actually bobby pin the curl to your head. So it will really let the curl cool down in that form, and it will look kind of crazy at first because it'll be so ringlety, but I promise it will keep the curls so much longer. So basically, instead of just letting it loose, you just take it up like this and bobby pin it to your head in the shape of the curl, and it will stay so much longer since you're letting that curl kind of dry down in that position. So fast, so easy. I love doing this. I'm not very great with hair. So anything simple is the way to go in my book. All right, and we are gonna do literally the exact same thing on the top. So we're gonna do the exact same thing. I work from the back and just move my way forward. And there's literally no rhyme or reason with this. I kind of just pick apart pieces. I feel like that's how it looks more natural anyways and kind of more beachy when you're not so uniform with everything. So I kind of just pick up a piece and curl it. A little trick I do though for some of the pieces on the very top of my head, so for instance this one, is I curl it, keep it on there for a little bit, and then hold it in my hand just a second, and then I take it across over to the other side of my head, which looks kind of funny. But what it does is it kind of lifts the curl, so when I take it back over, there's a little bit more volume to the hair. Take it back over. You see, there's just like a little bit more oomph. Coming together. And then for some of the very front pieces, I'll take the curling iron and just kind of go like this, just kind of giving it some volume. All right, let's finish the other side. Once I have it all curled, I kind of literally just play with it and mess around with it and make it a little bit looser and not as tight of a curl. So kind of just play with it. Swing my hair back and forth. So now for the best part is what I do to get a lot of texture and volume, and again to make it look a little bit more beachy and again like not so flat to my head, if you can kind of see. So it'll just give it a little bit more volume to where I can be like mm-mm, and it'll be like, you know? Okay, so the product that I use for that is this, and I love it. It is the Orbe, I think that's how you say it, dry texturizing spray, and it looks like this. And this kind of honestly acts like a hairspray a little bit, but this just adds volume and texture to the hair. So I spray it at the root first, and then I kind of work down into the curls. So I just kind of section off my hair and just do little sprays. I really focus it mainly like on the back crown of my head too, because I just feel like it's hard for me to get volume back there. So I just kind of work around doing quick little sprays, almost like dry hairspray, if that makes sense. And then I even work it into the curl. So I kind of like pull my hair out like this and spray it throughout my hair. It just kind of gives it more of a PC kind of look. Like an undone but put together look. That's what we want. Woo! All right, so once that's in my hair, then I just take my fingers, kind of massage it into my head. And then kind of take my fingers like this and just kind of like rough it up a little bit. But I mean, like, look how much volume my hair has now. I love it. And this texture spray, again, like I said, kind of acts like a hairspray as well. So that's why I don't use a hairspray when I use this texturizing spray. Hairspray isn't that great for your hair anyways. But this kind of holds the curl, so I really like it. It keeps the volume and without having to like tease your hair and kind of break it apart. So I love this spray. And look, it's nice and voluminous. And it was so easy to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I will link the texturizing spray as well as the curling iron that I used down below. And let me know if y'all end up trying out either of these products. I love them, and they have made the volume in my hair and the texture so easy to achieve. So let me know if you try this out, and thanks for watching. Bye.